Good evening. Just before we get started, if you wouldn't mind, with your cell phones, please turn those off or mute them, please. Just out of respect for our athletes, our guests, and the ceremony itself. I want to welcome everyone tonight. Hard to believe it's the end of the spring season. Finally, some decent weather. It's been a long haul with the rain. It seems to always show up on game or match day. So we're really happy we're here. So many people gathered together to celebrate our athletes, our coaches, and to celebrate our athletic program. So thank you for being here. And just to thank the parents and relatives and all the friends and families that are involved with our program and support our program. If we can have all of our athletes stand up and give them a round of applause.
Johnny's hair. I put it out for all of you that are returning. I have a great book that's out there for an all school read, and please read it. It's called Habits That Make a Champion. So when I was choosing my awards, I went back and looked at this book, and I'll just read you a few of the habits that these people have. But before we go any more, Matt, that takes care of the grounds crew, is probably absolutely one of the best there is. We have a great field because of him every day, so I'm very thankful for him. But with these guys, it's pretty special. This year we have two coaches awards. I'll read each person first, and then I'll get to our MVP. I normally don't give two coaches awards, but this year they're pretty special. So, habit 33 sums up this person. The habit of surrounding yourself by the right people. Surround yourself with good people. People who are going to be honest with you and look out for your best interests. That comes from Derek Jeter. Aim to distance yourself from the energy vampires, the gossipers, the rollers, the haters, those with no ambition to improve, those who are jealous of your success. As an athlete, you want to be surrounded by those who tell you the truth, challenge you to be better, support and encourage you, treat you with respect, inspire you to achieve excellence, are there for you during the good times and the bad times, even if you almost go over people. People who choose to surround themselves with either raise your standards or they're going to lower them, so choose wisely, and this is why I chose this person. This recipient is the type of person that you want to surround yourself with. He has raised the standards of what a Titan should be on the baseball field. He is a competitor, a great teammate, and has a tremendous work ethic. Ty is the guy that you want to build your team around, and it will be no surprise to me that he will be successful at St. John Fisher in the fall. He's a model Titan, and this year's Coach of the Award goes to Ty. Chips are down. This is a good one for everyone. The hard days are the best days because that's what makes a champion. It knows what champions are made of. So if you push through, you can push through anything. And that comes from Gabby Douglas. Being mentally tough is when you choose to keep a positive attitude when things aren't going your way. Champions succeed because they stay accountable for their own journey. They accept that they won't always have their day game. They stay positive under pressure. They don't make excuses or blame others. They compete until the end. Well, this player has been accountable for their own action and their own journey. He came to me and Coach Muzang in August before the school started without having a high school. He missed a year with injury. He had no college offers, and he played in no showcases. Jose had a plan, though, and faith in himself. By September, he was speaking with college coaches, crushing it in the classroom and in the gym, shooting out videos to college coaches, always grinding his way towards his goal, and all the while being grateful. I am very proud to have coached him. Needless to say, Union College just got a future engineer and a lead operator. The second coach of the world was a great coach. Champions don't rest on their laurels. They keep evolving to maintain a competitive edge. Our MVP this season has played through injury, positional changes. He embraces hard work. He's not shy to put long hours needed to be better, whether it's in the classroom, weight room, or on the ball field. He is what I refer to as a super competitor, and I've watched him evolve for over 6 years at the academy to become a complete student athlete. He can run, he can throw, he can feel, and he's one heck of a hitter. Wayne was named varsity captain during his junior year for his work ethic and demand for excellence from himself and his teammates. The coaching staff has selected Liam Shea Gallagher as this year's winner.
belt this time.
One of our most
makes her one of our top goal scorers. And she notched 48 goals this season. She also has a deep, unselfish streak, and as such, reported 21 assists with well-placed passes to her teammates. Finally, she inspires others with her tremendous work ethic. The 2024 Coach's Award goes to Katie Hatch.
Thank you to our team for giving your all every day and for giving us such a great conclusion to our in and I guess made it through. We only had, as we were saying, we only had one loss this season, which is a great record considering we went against like some of the best like D1, D2 schools in the league. And I am so excited and happy for our team's future.
Thank you.
to say what an honor it has been coaching these three MVPs for these 4 years. And not just because of their athletic ability, but they're amazing human beings. They're smart, funny, fun, driven, determined, passionate people. When Ariel first came out, she knew right away that she was going to be a sprinter, and she took on high jump, and then she also took on the triple jump, and the 300 hurdles, and the 4x1, and she was amazing. Mike immediately knew that he wanted to be a distance runner, and he did that with great talent. And then he picked up the pole vault just to mix it up a little, and ended up being really good at that too. But Abby didn't know what she was going to do. She tried distance, she tried sprinting, she went back and forth for a good amount before she finally settled on being a sprinter, and she threw the discus. And then that changed, and she became a long jumper. But these three hit the ground running on day one and haven't stopped for 4 years, getting PR after PR, and between the three of them, they have 10 school records. And they're very talented, and they will be scoring when they go off to college for their sports. So Mike has the school record for the 3,000, the 1,500, and the 4x4, and he's going off to run cross country at Columbia. And Abby has the school record for the 100, the 200, the 400, and the 4x1, and will be going off to do track and soccer at St. John Fisher. And Ariel has the school record for the triple jump, the high jump, the 300 hurdles, and the 4x1, and she's going to go off to toss next year.
Stuck in the parking lot at Great Horse, and you can't for the whole life. Captain, I'm staying for the varsity golf team. I would like to begin by calling out my co-captains to share some thoughts with you. Our first is a two-year starter. He is passionate, a student of the game, constantly looking to improve all aspects of the game in order to be the best golfer he can be. Junior, co-captain, Chris Calvin.
Thanks, Cal.
Good evening, everyone. During the year, we faced strong competition, unpredictable weather, and challenging courses, yet we battled through it all. I want to thank family, friends, and especially Coach Buzzy for helping us throughout the way. To all the boys, thank you for making this year so memorable, and I wish you all the best of luck.
He's a fierce competitor. Oftentimes, he is the team's medalist in both inter-squad scrimmages and matches. Help me welcome to the podium senior and pro captain Chris Paquette.
Could not thank you more.
miss you tremendously. So thank you, Coach Ernst. This group that you're looking at right now is just a quality group of student athletes and certainly student leaders. And I go back to the beginning of the season when I asked them to write down their goals for the season, both individual and team goals. I collect those and read them. It's interesting to read, and I appreciate that piece of it. About the midpoint of the season, I asked them to write down on a piece of paper, what has been your biggest challenge this season? And I collect those, and as I read those, I really began to realize that, you know, the goals are important, what they think that they want to accomplish as a team and individuals. But halfway through the season, they begin to identify things that they have to overcome as individuals and as members of the team, issues that they've had to solve, difficulties that they've had to deal with, not just with the sport that they play, but also the individuals on their team. As they, some of these larger teams, just the cohesiveness, the cooperation, the conflicts that sometimes emerge, the stress of maybe not being successful individually or as a team. And those are reflected in those comments that they made. We also spent time in a meeting having them talk about that with the fellow captains in the team, but also with the group. And it's the only time, really, during the course of the year, where they sit around a big table in the conference room and look across that table at fellow captains and have a chance to exchange what they go through, what they deal with, and what they're trying to accomplish. And really, it's a great moment to listen to that as they have that kind of interchange. I walk away from those meetings being very grateful for the type of student athlete we have, but most importantly, the type of student leadership we have. And so I would like to have us all give a round of applause for this great collection of team captains.
Thank you. Hey, Buck. My team.
You guys think tennis is pretty cool?
Tennis is pretty cool.
Thank you to WMA Lacrosse and the best of luck to everyone in the future. Thanks. But he's got two championships under his belt in his time here, and we wish him the best of luck as he moves on to play college lacrosse next year. Great job, Andrew.
Hi, I'm Camila, and I'm
England for always being there to fix our team up and use a lot of our team. Thank you, Ms. Micah, for also helping the team and supporting us. Thank you, Mr. Weeks, for always having a smile and giving us our uniforms and supporting us. Thank you, Emily, for also teaching us in the gym and the girls who are invested in the sport and for you helping them. And thank you guys for your help. Without you guys, our season would not have been possible. And we are very thankful for the hard work put into this team.
Hi, everyone. I'm here to present the MVP this year, and I'm
Tonight we gather to celebrate a student athlete who may not always be in the spotlight, but whose contributions are the very essence of our team's success. They embody the heart and soul of our team, consistently demonstrating selflessness, dedication, and an unwavering commitment to our collective goals this year. She is the glue that holds us together, always ready to lift her teammates up. Her positive energy and smile are contagious. Her presence on and off the pitch has been instrumental in making us strong and unified for the team we are today. It was not difficult for us to decide to support given her generous nature and consistent support of her teammates. Every program, be it last place team or first place finisher, has that one teammate who just has that one intangible that is so important to the makeup of a team. She leads and contributes on and off the pitch. She understands her role and maximizes her minutes when called upon as a starter, a sub, or even a cheerleader. Although injuries and bad fortune haunted her through her career thus far, she showed up every day and still compiled match starts and most tackles in a single game. You are a cornerstone of this team, and we are better because of you. It's our privilege and honor to announce the Coach's Award that goes to Mariana Mojica.
I just really want to say a huge thank you to my
at every route, gets at every tackle, and is able to recycle themselves and get to the next play. This is a first-year player for us, someone who has learned the game, taking the skills he's learned from football, brought them over to rugby. He is not the biggest guy out there. He's like medium strong, Tucker, right? I don't know how we describe it, like medium strong. But is the most fierce guy out there. He's the first to practice every day, and we wouldn't have had the season we have today without him. So, Tucker, congratulations.
We also wanted to express our appreciation to Madam Wall and Jay Hamilton, our
also bring their characteristic energy and enthusiasm to the court. Thank you. This season, I was beyond excited to work with this group of girls specifically. I wholeheartedly believe that this team has shown the support and dedication that truly represents our core values here at WN. From our middle schooler to our three wonderful seniors, you all embody the meaning of live clean, speak true, work hard, and play fair. Despite some difficulties with weather and rescheduling, I want all my girls to know that I'm beyond proud to serve the 2024 Girls Varsity Tennis Team.
I've got two special things. Thank you to my associate coach, Madame Dubois, who smooths out some of the rough edges in my personality. And I gotta thank, an extra thanks go to Miss Whipple, who kept Emma in one piece this year.
Thank you. coming up. So we got a shock. Good stuff.
Next up, boys tennis. Coach Desmond.
Spread the team spirit and make a team chemistry with new players.
each year, the fall, winter, and spring. It's difficult enough to take on playing one varsity sport during the season, but to sustain that throughout the school year and to do it for three seasons is truly outstanding. I'd like to invite my staff to please come over to the table as we make these presentations. I want to read the student-athletes' name and the sports that they participate in during their senior year. Ariel Bateman. Soccer, winter track, track and field.
Ariel, go on stage. Thank you.
top row.
Durango picture. So let's do something else.